إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا هادينا ومرشدنا أفضلنا وأكرمنا وأعلانا إمامنا وقدوتنا سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا وعن سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يقول إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى إلى آخره متفق عليه. Last week we spoke about the prayer, the salah, and the connection of having khushu' to the prayer, having concentration, having tranquility in our prayers, and that khushu', having this attribute of being tranquil and having concentration in your prayer, this is a part of the salah. That the greater our khushu' is, the greater our reward is. The less our khushu' is, the lesser our reward will be. And today we'll speak about one of the conditions, one of the shara'it of the not only the salah, any act of worship that we perform, any deed that we perform to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of which salah, prayer is among the greatest of them. But any act of worship, any deed that we perform to gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then among the shara'it, among the shurut, the conditions for that to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what we'll speak about today. Otherwise, if our ibadat, if our worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is missing in its conditions, in that which is meant to be there, then our deeds will become, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. That we shall present, we shall put forth what they came with in terms of their deeds, what they performed, فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And we shall make those deeds into scattered particles of dust. All those years of working hard, toiling and troubling to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to face Him on Yawmul Qiyamah, to be in the court of Allah Dhul Jalali wal Ikram, and your deeds which you performed, all of them to be ruined and to be made into scattered particles of dust. فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And that is from the shara'it of ibadah, of worship to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether salah, zakah, siyam, hajj, whatever it may be, the minada among them is the person must have tawheed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They must be a muwahid. They must have belief in one Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. And coupled with that, they must perform that action to be in accordance to the tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. What we'll speak about today is the third one. The third among the shara'it for the qubuliyya, the acceptance of our deeds, is al-ikhlas. is having sincerity, having genuinity, having this characteristic in yourself of being mukhlis, of having ikhlas, having sincerity, which the Imam of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, Imam Abu Abdullah Ahmed bin Muhammad bin Hanbal al-Shaybani rahmahullahu ta'ala, he defined it as being إِذَا عَمِلْتَ عَمَلًا لَا تُرِيدُ بِهِ الدُّنْيَا. That when you perform any deed, what does it mean to be sincere, to have ikhlas? Whenever you perform any action, any deed which you perform to gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do not want from that anything from this dunya. Any mansab, any position, any shuhra, any fame, any thana, any praise from the people, nothing except you want the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahmahullah ta'ala, he said, talking about ikhlas, he said that inna niyyata bimanzilati ar-ruh, that this intention, this what we objectify by our deeds, our ikhlas, our sincerity, in regards to the deed which we perform, the relationship between ikhlas, between our niyyah, between our intention, our sincerity, and any act which we perform, then the correlation between them is like the soul to a body. بِمَنْزِلَةِ الرُّوحِ مِنَ الْجَسَدِ is like the position that the soul has in the body of a person. إِذَا فَارَقَ الرُّوحِ, when the soul departs, then that body is dead. When the niyyah is corrupted, when the ikhlas is polluted, when there is no sincerity in that, all there is riya and sum'ah. All there is wanting to be heard, wanting to be seen, wanting to be praised by the people. No portion is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For His pleasure and His pleasure alone, Jalla wa Ala, then it is as if your action is dead. It is like a dead body without any ruh inside of it. This is ikhlas, having sincerity, which was in actuality the call of all of the messengers alayhim as-salatu was-salam. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They were not commanded, the people to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His messengers, they were not commanded except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, being sincere to Him in their religion. And for the rectification of our intention, for the build-up of our ikhlas, to have the correctness of our sincerity, then this is what requires mujahada, working hard and practicing, working against our soul, against our nafs, to please nobody other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for that reason, from the Imams of the Salaf, Imam Sufyan bin Sa'id al-Thawri rahmahullah ta'ala, he used to say, مَا عَالَجْتُ شَيْئًا أَشَدُّ عَلَيَّ مِن نِيَّتِي فَإِنَّهَا تَتَقَلَّبُ عَلَيَّ. I have never ever treated anything, I have never given treatment for anything more difficult upon me, أَشَدُّ عَلَيَّ مِن نِيَّتِي, than my intention. Making sure my niyyah is correct, making sure, why am I intending only and only the ridwan and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّهَا تَتَقَلَّبُ عَلَيَّ, because the intention, our ikhlas, is always and always changing and altering from position to position, from this to that. Hence why it is extremely difficult to keep under control your niyyah, a lifelong mission, throughout all of our worship, in the beginning of our worship, in the middle and in the end. Check your niyyah. What is it that you intend? Who is it that you're trying to please? Is it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or is it somebody other than Him, Jalla wa Ala? Sayyiduna Abu Umamah al-Bahili radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, in the Sunan of al-Imam Abu Abdurrahman Ahmad bin Shu'aib al-Nasa'i rahmahullahu ta'ala, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبَلُ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ إِلَّا مَا كَانَ لَهُ خَالِصًا وَابْتُغِيَ بِهِ وَجْهُهُ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never accept, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبَلُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from an action, from a deed which anybody performs, except that which was done خَالِصًا, purely and sincerely for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَابْتُغِيَ بِهِ وَجْهُهُ, wanting to seek the countenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, the dhabit for to keep our niyyah in check is that we do not want any praise from anybody. We do not want the thanks from anybody, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He mentions the abrar, the pious people in Surah Al-Insan, that they say, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّي مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. They give from food, they feed over their love for it, those who are masakeen, those who are poor, those who are destitute, those who are orphans, those who are captives. What is their intention behind their giving of food? Between feeding these people which are destitute, which are helpless, what is their niyyah? What is their intention? What do they want by that? إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only and only feed you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We do not want from you any thanks, we do not want from you any recompense, any prize, any reward, any praise from you, nothing. All we are seeking by this deed is the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how many ahadith do all of us know which show us the importance of having ikhlas, having sincerity in our deeds? Take for example the hadith we all know in the Sahihain of Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there was a woman who passed by a dog by the side of a well. كَادَ يَقْتُلُهُ الْعَطَشُ. He was about to die from his thirst. إِذْ رَأَتْهُ بَغْيٌ مِّن بَغَايَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. When a lewd woman from the Banu Israel saw him, فَنَزَعَتْ مُوقَهَا. So she took off her footwear. فَسَقَتْهُ فَغُفِرَ لَهَا بِهِ. And so she fed him, she quenched the thirst of this dog. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave her for her sins because of this one deed. Again in the Sahihain, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, بَيْنَمَا رَجُلٌ يَمْشِي بِطَرِيقٍ. When a man was walking in the pathways, وَجَدَ غُصْنَ شَوْكٍ فَأَخَذَهُ. He found a thorny branch, so he took it and removed it. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was thankful for this, and Allah dhul jalali wal ikram forgave him. Is any woman who is a prostitute, she feeds, she quenches the thirst of any dog, will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her for that? Will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her admittance into paradise? Any person who removes anything from the street, will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala automatically give them paradise for that? No, there is something missing. What is that? The ikhlas of these people. The sincerity of theirs was such that they were so sincere and genuine, seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this was the reward for their deeds. That Allah dhul jalali wal ikram, He forgave them. Because it is ikhlas, it is our sincerity, it is our genuinity towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only and only seeking to please Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, that makes our deeds which are small, our deeds which are minuscule, our deeds which are worthless, magnifies them in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is our ikhlas, it is our sincerity that makes our deeds which are small, large in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لهذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه الغفور. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين نبينا ورسولنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد. So how is it that we alter our deeds, we change them and we make them to be mukhlisa, we make our deeds to be purely, sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then among the ways by which we can purify our deeds, purify our a'mal, our ibadat, make them sincere for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to number one, hide our deeds. To hide our deeds which we perform. Is it the fact that we perform Qiyamul Layl? We pray all night seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the following morning, everybody knows that I prayed Qiyamul Layl. Is that what we call as ikhlas? Was that done sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Rather, we find in the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, Saba'a alladhina yudhilluhum Allah fi dhilli yawma la dhilla illa dhillu, the seven categories of people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shade on the day of resurrection when there is no shade except the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is there among them? وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَ فَأَخْفَاهَا حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمُ شِمَالُهُ مَا تُنْفِقُ يَمِينُهُ. A person who he gave in charity, such sadaqah, such charity, hatta la ta'lamu shimalu ma tunfiqu yaminu, to such an extent which his left hand had no idea what his right hand gave in sadaqah, meaning he hid his charity so much, nobody knew what he gave for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَرَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ, a man, a person who they remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they remembered Allah dhul jalali wal ikram, made dhikr of him subhanahu wa ta'ala, خَالِيًا, in seclusion, in privacy, without anybody seeing them and observing them, فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ, and their eyes shed tears, their eyes welled up with tears because of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, showing us to hide our good deeds, not to broadcast them on Facebook, on Snapchat, on Twitter, on Instagram, to hide your good deeds. Hiding them, concealing your good deeds is what develops in them ikhlas. Among them also is to trivialize your good deeds. What do I mean by trivializing your good deeds? Sa'id ibn Jubayr rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that perhaps a person may perform a good deed, فَمَا زَالَ مُعْجِبًا بِهَا, and he remains astonished, happy and pleased by his own good deed, وَلَقِيَ اللَّهَ بِهَا, and he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that, فَأَدْخَلَهُ النَّارِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will throw him in the fire of Jahannam. Why? Because he was astonished, amazed by his own good deeds. Never think your good deeds are good enough to grant you entrance into paradise. Trivialize your good deeds. They are nothing worthless in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you forgotten the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Sahih Muslim, where the three people, أَوَّلُ مَن تُسَعَّرُ بِهِمُ النَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the first three people who the fire of Jahannam will be ignited by them on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, who are they? Evil people. Who are they, the greatest tyrants this world has seen? Who are they, the greatest mushrikeen this world has seen? No. A person who recited the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person who fought on the battlefield. And a person who spent their wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? لِيُقَالَ جَرِي لِيُقَالَ قَارِ لِيُقَالَ جَوَّاد, in order that it was said, he is a qari. The people would say, they had no ikhlas in their deeds. Their deeds were not done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And lastly, for us to concentrate, to ponder, to reflect upon the deeds of those who came before us, the way that they worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to look at our own selves and see how far disconnected we are from our worship and their worship. Their worship, the worship of the Sahaba, of the Tabi'een, of our Aslaf alayhim ridwan, and how dedicated they were in their ikhlas and in their sincerity to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَى اللَّهِ فَبِهُدَاهُ مُقْتَدِي, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, take a precedent, take an example, follow up from the righteous who came before you. Compare your good deeds with their good deeds and you'll realize your good deeds are nothing compared to theirs. What is it that will make your good deeds large in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You cannot compete with them. It is your ikhlas. It is your sincerity. It is your genuinity. You are only and only wanting the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wanting to please Him jalla wa ala, which will grant you entrance into paradise, which will grant you the acceptance of your good deeds. It is your ikhlas. It is time for us to work on our ikhlas, to develop ikhlas in our hearts for all the types of worship which we perform, whether we stand for salah, whether we give in sadaqah, whether we go on hajj, whatever it is, make sure that you have in yourself ikhlas. Make sure that you are not one of those people who is doing your good deed, your deed which apparently is good, to show off to people, for people to say and for people to see. نسأل الله السلامة والعافية ونكتفي بهذا. هذا ما عندي والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم بالصواب. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان وجعلنا مع الراشدين. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وعيوننا من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, وأذل الشرك والمشركين, ودمر أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا, اللهم اغفر لنا ولجميع موتانا وموتى المسلمين, واشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم, وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين.